Good evening, friends. Welcome on this special webinar on the automation and with this automation achieve the efficiency in your professional firm. The compliance and the due dates are so many nowadays, and the extension of above that. We have already so many due dates already as per the law, as per the act, as per the rules and regulation, and above that we have so many extension and due date extending also two, three, four times. So it is a difficult for a individual or a practitioner to follow up with the each and every due date. How we can do maintain the track record of all that? So we have a today automation on the compliance calendar. We have a fantastic speaker with us, CA Mudit Goyal. He has developed one of the best solution as well for all of us. So Mudit ji will explain all this with us. Before I invite Mudit Goyal ji for the today's session, would like to invite our friend and our joint this webinar is we are doing jointly with Jain Chartered Accountant Federation. So Puneet Bhai Mehta is a technology man. He is an expert in the tele part as well and the five star tele partner. Would like to invite Puneet Bhai for the welcome address on behalf of Jain Chartered Accountant Federation. So over to you, Puneet.
Good afternoon, all. And on behalf of Jain Chartered Accountant Federation, I welcome all the participants to this wonderful webinar for automation. As we had mentioned in the mail, that automation not only increases the business efficiency of business, but it also helps in managing and reducing the cost of the business. So it is useful in all aspects. At JCAF, we have always been encouraging for the members to grow up, scale up, and reduce the cost. And when Virag Bhai gave the opportunity or they discussed about this, I was really happy that we have connected on this, and we are jointly doing this program along with Connect Easy. And I welcome all the participants. Have a wonderful learning and ensure that we take out the best out of it. How automation can help us out, and not only basic automation, but it also would include the aspects which are related to what one may say is the artificial intelligence, which is very much required in today's day. How we can keep track of this. So with those words, I would welcome all the participants to enjoy today's program and take maximum advantage of this particular software which Mudit Bhai is going to share with us.
Thank you so much, Puneet Bhai, for your welcome address and inviting all and have the benefit. Now would like to request our today's speaker, Mudit Goyal. He is himself a chartered accountant and product of Big Four as well for this fantastic session. So over to you, Mudit Bhai. You can now share screen as well.
Thank you. Mr. Virag Shah and the entire Connect Easy team for giving me this opportunity to share our product with everyone. And more than product, today's session we are conducting upon how to manage the CA practice with efficiency, with tools like compliance management and client management. So in today's webinar, we'll not only be discussing what are the problems and why these kind of solutions are required, but we guarantee that by the end of webinar, we'll also be presenting you solutions that you can implement your entity within a day or two. So why the need for these kind of efficiency has come up, other than the basic factors like technology is taking over and the number of compliances in the industry have increased. There is another business factor that we call as the balancing act. So as you can see on the screen, there is a triangle in which we have placed three parameters. So, forgive me that I would like to introduce. So, I'm CA Mudit Goyal, and I'm the founder of Firmsa Ventures Private Limited, a financial automation and product R&D company. I have 5 years of experience of automation with MNCs and even CA firms, and in providing financial automation and sometimes developing independent products for them. So coming back to the presentation, so we call this a balancing act. The business of each CA firm is dependent upon three factors: average revenue per unit, quality they are providing, and the cost of that providing that quality. Now, we all know that with advent of GST and a lot of professionals jumping into it, the cost, the revenue that we are able to earn per unit of our client is very low. People are not ready to pay even for factors like GST audit and GST return filing. The cost, the fees have declined substantially to like 500,000. This kind of fees we are getting. So I have tried to develop an analogy how this decrease in revenue is affecting the our profits and practice. So when we try to increase the quality, it leads to increase in cost, which ultimately requires an increase in average revenue per unit. But as we have all seen, that is going down and that is directly affecting our quality. So the only solution that we have is implementing technology that actually works. So here is another model that we can use. So if we say that with a decrease in average revenue that we are getting per client, we need to increase the number of units in order to maintain the current revenue. But with increase in units, we again have to hire more staff to interact with those people to do their compliances. So the market, we can say, has reached an equilibrium not only in India but worldwide for freelancers and professionals due to increase in labor cost and the paying capacity of the market. So as a professional also, we most of the firms have taken a great hit due to COVID, and the amount of revenue they are able to generate is equivalent to what a professional would earn in job also. So this is like the very common problem which we'll be solving today. So this is about what kind of solutions are required in CA industry today. So there are a lot of operational softwares and operational software that are available in the market. But what is needed is a client-facing, collaborative, RPA-based solutions that maintains centralized and standardized repository. Now, elaborating on that, client-facing system means, like most of the softwares in that CA firms are using today are limited to their own CA firm environment, and no information is reaching the clients. The exchange of information with clients is still going on in mails and WhatsApp chats. And CA firms have not been able to provide a platform for those people so that they can access their information in a centralized manner. Collaborative, because today no CA firm is doing all the work. That work is distributed between some income tax practitioners, GST practitioners, some MCA lawyers, accountants, and even the business owners. So all these stakeholders are playing some kind of role in the financial management and legal management of the company, and they need to be on the same platform so as to they can collaborate on the information. RPA is robotic process automation. It is a relatively new technology, which means that most of the processes that we do manually are done by computers using virtual machine platforms. This means that if you are taking 10 Excel files and merging them one by one, what RPA will do, it will pick up each file for you and collaborate it. And it will do it in the same manner as you do it. It won't be linked through an API or an automation project. It will be a bot that will actually do the clicks that you do. So this is called RPA technology, and it is very much usable in our profession. When I say centralized and standardized repository, this is very important. Because if we want to analyze something, we not only want to have everything at one place, we need to have it in a standardized format also. For example, tomorrow government launches a law that everyone having 50,000 or above sales per month, they have to pay a certain tax. Now, if you have a centralized repository of all the client sales per month, you can, using a simple formula, extract that information. But if all that information is lying with all your employees at separate places, it would be difficult. Now, even though the information is centralized, you will be able to apply a single formula only when the database is standardized. So what I'm trying to say here is the database needs to be centralized and standardized for all our clients. And that is possible. That is like if we want to do it manually, it would obviously incur a lot of cost for our firms. And obviously it will increase the quality, but again, the cost factor kicks in And with the average return, average revenue we are getting, it becomes not justifiable. So why collaboration is important? As I explained, there are multiple parties, accountants, employees of chartered accountant, different professionals who are filing different return. And then when the information is placed together, there is a view of the company management that how they see the business. Sometimes when you see a story from a bird eye view, you get some different views, some different analysis, and some different inferences of that data. So this becomes important to centralize the data at least once a year. And and rather than once a year, if we are doing it on a real-time basis, it is even more useful. So the kind of softwares today available, we have classified into four categories. So the first is return filing softwares, which most of us are using. But according to my vision, that return filing softwares will be done away in a matter of 2 years, because the way government is working towards automating the return filing process, like most of the GST return filings are done through government portal only, and no software is used, because the portal is much easier than to use any other software. Then there are accounting softwares like Tally, Busy, and now some online softwares are also coming, like Zoho and QuickBooks, which are being used by a lot of firms now. Then we have management softwares like employee and fixed asset management softwares. So payroll softwares are becoming very famous. It was an initiative by someone at some point in time, and then it caught on, and people saw the how much ease it provides in terms of managing the clients and their payroll. It started catching on, and now very big players have entered into this market. And the fourth kind of softwares that are like gradually taking over are analytical softwares. So how we draw the line between operational and analytical softwares is that operational softwares help us do something, but analytical software is a collection of all those operational data points, and it is providing you a bird eye view of the entire system. So in compliance tracking softwares, you are not actually doing the compliance. What you are doing is that you are maintaining a record of all the compliances that have been done, and by whom it has been done, and whether it was done late or not, any penalties have been incurred. So these kind of softwares are required. So I have prepared short 3 points on why this kind of softwares are currently missing from the industry. So for any software to be analytical, we say that a lot of data points are required. So for that data points, API integration is required. API integration and integration of other software, agility is required. But when we are building that are desktop based, a lot of agility is not possible due to the software limitations. Then it needs to be SaaS based. SaaS based means it should be online, accessible as softwares like Facebook, so that you can just go on online through any device and enter your information over there. But over the period, we have seen that entities and chartered accountants are skeptical about entering their data online due to fear of data security. Now, I would like to focus on this point by saying that even ICI in one of its webinar actually said that online databases are more secure, because as a server that you are maintaining in your CA firm, in your entity, is you are the only one protecting it through firewalls. But when it is companies like AWS, DigitalOcean, and Google, they are protecting it with a team as large as companies just to maintain the data security. So online data is more secure rather than maintaining servers in your office, and it is cheaper also. Thirdly, and the last point is that there is no investment in UI and UX. In India, we have seen a great deal of products which are like very useful. But the user experience that they provide and the user interface that they provide is not that good. And part of the reason is, again, the desktop softwares, because they are not that much equipped with the technology. So discussing about how the world is responding to adoption of technology in our field. When we talk about, so I have taken three major countries where most of the investments are going on and most of the startup work is going on: US, UK, and Singapore. So UK is particularly famous for its data security laws, and for that reason, the platform, this
Qualys is a platform for particularly GRC compliances. US has a lot of platforms. Basically, Carta and Shoebox are for your equity management, cap table management. Clerkey is a very good concept. Most of you might be aware of it. It is an online registration platform like firstbase.io. If you want to incorporate a company in US, you can simply upload your documents there and you can get the registration done. This process is becoming famous in India also, but that is also a problem that people in India have launched these kind of platforms. But once the people get registration, they are suffering because they are unable to track their compliances effectively because they don't know what kind of compliances are applicable to them, what kind of due dates are there, and when these compliances have become overdue. In Singapore, we have a special platform which is a service listing and client service module. So this platform has particularly adopted this for providing information to their clients and interacting with their clients. They have created this platform where you can go and ask them doubts and get your services done. Like even if you want to get your returns filed, they help you by providing you a chat box where you can chat and exchange views with them, and then they do your work by collecting the payment online only. So this is the world view where people have adopted, and countries have overall shifted their legal and financial compliance structure to online platforms. Now, this statistics, as all of the chartered accountants are here, so you must be aware of that 30% of all companies, around 3.5 lakh companies, were struck down due to non-compliance. 4,200 crores is the average penalty collection by GST department. And GST department has started linking their data to income tax department, which has led to a lot of notices for the clients. And lastly, the 20 lakh registrations are done online every year. So for these registrations, the chartered accountants and professionals are not particularly in touch with the client. They are in touch with the client only for the purpose of a particular registration, which leads to discrepancy in information exchange and post-service, post-registration services, which if we have a client, then we take care of by informing them time to time that what kind of compliances they need to do. So currently, we can say that we are working on a reactive approach. We are waiting for audits, notices, penalties, and even client to come to us that, okay, my this compliance is additional that I need to do, or this complaint is and this compliance is pending. Then we have a proactive approach. In proactive approach, we can Suomoto provide a single login to the client for all their data, provide them active penalty tracking, compliance tracking, what kind of cases are pending, and GST reconciliation. So here I would like to say that as much as we have discussed, if any of you want to like ask any questions or have any points, I would be happy to discuss. So you can put it in the chat box and I'll take that up. So what is the adoption cycle of technology in India? So adoption cycle in India is like most of the firms have not adopted it because of lack of internal technology teams and adoption teams. But Big Fours, as they always have rigorous internal systems of softwares where they like control their teams and provide service to their clients, and even GRC compliance tools and such tools. Then there are consultancy firms. So many chartered accountants have created a layer of consultancy firm over their CA firms due to restriction by ICAI, and they are promoting themselves online. So these are basically client listing, service listing websites where people have listed themselves. Then there are accounting firms who have taken up Zoho and QuickBooks as a medium of accounting, which provides a client-facing solution. So if they are accounting, they are doing accounting at a point, even client gets an access. Even Tally has launched its recent modules where they are providing online access. So it is not that technology has not seeped into India, but the kind of solutions are just operational, and the adoption is very fearful adoption, we can see. and the solutions are basically, because of the fearful adoption, the companies are also hesitant to come into India for building solutions. So what this solution is about, we don't call it a compliance solution. We just call it an early detection and warning system for legal and finance, because it not only takes care of your compliances, it connects your data to your financial data like Tally, and then it also takes care of penalties and exposure related risks and document creation and data storage of your client. So like we maintain a permanent file for our clients, even that can be maintained. So what kind of problems are there, like particularly problems we can see in the compliance tracking softwares that we have solved, and some are still not solved, but they are in progress. So when we go to onboard a compliant or implement a compliance software, there is a prolonged onboarding. This creates a great barrier, because once we have committed to onboarding our entire firm into a software, then the process should be fast. Due to this prolonged onboarding process, many of the people drop, and it also creates a distance between the company and the professionals. Then we have seen that in most of the software, you have to manually make the compliance applicable for each of your client. So if you have 100 clients, you have to go and manually make the compliance applicable for each of the clients. So they lack the AI and automation part in their systems. It is just like a listing of compliances where you can mark them and track them. Then there is manual tracking. For example, if you have implemented a compliance software and you have 100 clients and 10 employees, you have allotted 10 entities to each of your employees. Now, whenever they do the compliance, they have to go to the software and mark it as complete. Only then you will be able to see whether the compliance is done or not in your centralized dashboard. Now, this creates another roadblock in implementation, because employees see it as an additional task, which actually is for reporting, and they see it as a check on them and they run away from it. Then there is a cost factor. So these softwares are charging per user with minimum commitment of 5 to 10 users, which creates a cost barrier for chartered accountant. As we just discussed, that our average revenue per unit is decreasing. So the solution should be affordable and scalable. So it should not be that I have to pay the same price for our 20-30 clients and same price for 1,000 clients. So a firm which grows, the pricing should grow with the firm, and not they should initially charge a hefty amount. And there is no interlinked databases. As I said, that these softwares are simply relying on tracking the compliance. There is a lot of data that is attached to each compliance. That data needs to be stored and analyzed as well. We need to store some files, some data points to actually ensure that the compliance was done. And it also they also lack a feature that is linking to their Tally or any other financial software. So that when financial softwares are connected, it gives us an opportunity to actually analyze on the basis of our accounting data whether the compliance is complete or not. For example, if a person is paying hefty amounts to Google and he's not doing an equalization levy compliance, then the system can actually red flag that whether you have done that, that you should do this compliance. And most of these softwares are running on risk-based factors. They do not actually tell you the penalty or exposures that you have. So they'll tell you that, okay, 3B has a risk rate of 8, then TDS return has a risk rate of 7, but they do not actually tell you that what kind of penalty is pending against you in a particular compliance. So as we discussed that these are all the problems that we have discussed. I have categorized into 3 parts. One is the compliance problem, then is the permanent file problem, that the documents that we need to store for a particular company, and then there is exposure related problems like penalties and whether the accounting of that client is updated and the cases pending against them. So I have tried to put it in a perspective where you will be able to see the impact of the data points that we have and the cost that we save when we automate these kind of things. So we can say that each firm has multiple clients who are situated in multiple states having multiple registrations, and each registration obviously has multiple compliances. So starting with the basic of 100 entities who might be having 5 registrations each, which is very nominal to assume, and then each of those registration has 10 compliances. So on an annual basis, a CA firm would be incurring around 5,000 compliances, which will be again then done by different departments in different locations. And documentary records like certificates, copies of returns, due date, extensions, acknowledgement, challan copies, and the filing status have to be tracked on daily basis. So a close to 50,000 data points are generated in a firm every year. So this kind of data is huge. And to maintain this in Excel file, the kind of money that will be spent and to analyze that, the kind of effort that will be required is tremendous. So this is what we have tried to cover for professionals. We call it the Legally solution, where 100 plus bots. So these are robots that run on software that will collect 75% of all data points for you automatically. So this feature is automated tracking, whereby it will fetch information from all the public databases and provide you a centralized picture. For example, if you have done GST return filing for 10 of your clients today, it will show you that, okay, these compliances are done. You don't even need to ask your employees to actually do it, to mark whether the compliances have been done. So if your 100 clients are, 100 employees are filing returns simultaneously, as soon as they are done, it will reflect on the platform in your desktop that, okay, these compliances have been done. The platform is like collaborative. You can share a same entity with your fellow professionals, your employees, shareholders, clients, and whether you want to give them a write access or just an edit access, that is up to you. Then you can also connect your tally to view an MIS on your software. So now I'll actually show you how these things work. So what all we have covered is GST, TDS, income tax, ESI, PF, trademark, and company law. We'll be discussing one more problem where we must be having trademark lawyers and people who are into trademarks. So we have developed an AI-based solution for trademark lawyers also. And many lawyers have already started using it and they find it like extremely useful. So the problem we have is the original trademark process is we go from application to examination to approval, and then there is a renewal process. So initially how the tracking works is only the lawyer has all the information about a trademark. He only receives a mail about whether the trademark has been approved, it has been objected, or whether it has been marked for exam, and client doesn't receive any information. So it becomes a challenge for the professional to actually inform each and every client what is the status of their compliance right now, what is the status of their trademark right now. Then there are 4,000, after the trademark is even registered, like we have gone through the status change process and the trademark is registered, then there are 4,000 weekly trademarks. So you have to do a matching process for all of them, whether the trademark has breached by any trademark. So that is another problem. And then obviously the renewal reminders. So to be able to remember the same So here we'll discuss specifically how we have solved these problems. So managing entity and registration data. So how the data today we have is unstructured. For example, we have companies, their shareholder and directors, their family, and then associated entities. We need to store information like name, address, contact information, bank details, certificates, and KYC documents of these all these entities. So I'll just directly jump into the platform. So as you can see, when you enter the platform, this will be your main dashboard. So you can add any of your entity just by clicking that add new, and then you can add the name, and there are 10 kind of entities that we have covered, including a foreign entity if it is outside India. Then once you enter this, you have a manage entity tab where you can store most of the information of your client, like entire KYC documents and everything. So So as you can see that you can store personal details. So in case of company, although it is as it is linked to government portal like MCA, it will automatically fetch some of your information. So like personal details, documents, contact details, and bank account details. Then we have share capital details. You can create an entire shareholding structure in this. It is a very detailed structure that you can create in this, including your interest rate if it is a debt capital. Then you have shareholders information. Now shareholders are also can be any kind of entity. They can be individuals and society or partnership firms. They can be anything. Then you have KMP and employees information. Here the director information is automatically fetched from the MCA portal and put here. And again, directors can only be individual. So you can store the entire KYC of a director within this platform. Then we have ownerships and membership structure, where you can store the ownership of that company for any particular entity. Then you get entire document structure. So this way, the permanent file that you maintain for any entity is maintained within this, and you can share this as a read file or an edit file with your company. So as you can see, that multiple entities to choose from, entire array of information that you can store, and it is better than the current structure that most of us are following, like Excel sheets, Google Sheets, our closed Google computer drives, mobile and WhatsApp storages, and office files. So this is all what we have discussed. So there is an additional part that it also has available as an app. So you can even do it in your phone, the entire managing part. Then you can add. So how the structure in this software works is, first you add an entity, then you add all the registration of that entity, and then the entire compliance structure of that entity gets automatically created when you add a registration, and you can edit it. So moving on to how the registrations can be added, we'll go to this part. So you can see that the entire registration structure is here. You can add any kind of registration along with further details about that registration. So if I go to edit this, I can see that I can see other details that I can enter for this particular entity. So going back to registration structure, when you add any entity, the software automatically makes basic compliances applicable to that client. For example, when you add GST, it will automatically make applicable GSTR 1, 3B, 9 for you. It will even go to government portal and fetch information that which terms have to apply, and it will create the entire calendar with the compliances that are coming. So moving on to how the dashboard of an entity when information is added looks. So you can see that there is an entire structure of basic details. Then what kind of registrations you already have. And if you want to add a new one, you can directly do it from this dashboard. Then for compliances, I get a compliance structure where I can see my filed overdue and upcoming compliances. In my upcoming compliances part, I can see the compliances that are upcoming. And if there is an extension, the notification will be here. So as you know that today, a lot of notifications have come, they will be reflected in the software in a day or two. Then even the TDS penalty is real time reflected here. And then this is a document structure we'll be discussing in a while. So if we see that what kind of compliances structure, how the compliance structure in the software is working. So when you add, as I said, that when you add any compliance, it automatically fetches the information and marks the compliances that you have done as filed. So as you can see that some of my compliances are showing as filed. So you don't need to do it manually. The software does it for you. It even goes on to add some additional information for that compliance. So there is a tab when you have and mark the compliances file, you get a tab to enter details also. So as you can see, it is showing that the return was filed on 23rd October. So this is automatic. So if my compliance is done by my accountant or CA, he is filing the return from his own portal, but it will show me real-time status without human intervention. And if I want to upload a 3B file or a calculation file, I can just add on the options over here itself. So now I'll show you. So this is how the compliance structure is working. I get a simple dashboard for the filed, overdue, and upcoming compliances. And I can filter it by a lot of parameters. So this gives me the flexibility to see what kind of view I want. Okay, so this is a sharing module we'll discuss. So there, in this software, you can even connect your Tally. So the problems with the Tally today are there is no real-time tracking for the business owners in form of an MIS. They don't need to see each and every entry. They just need an overview, which is currently missing. Lack of access from anywhere, then lack of backup. So the backup is only in Tally. So in this software, if you sync your Tally, it also maintains a backup for you. Then there is no reporting according to business needs. So it creates some of the very good charts that you can provide to your clients, including debtor and creditor aging modules, where you can see that which payment from which client is pending for what period. So these are all the reports that it generates. So this is how the reports look. So these are, I'll show you to you in real time. So we can just go to Tally dashboards and click to dashboard. So yeah, it will load in a minute. So I'll explain you. So this is showing the total income, total expense, and total profit. Then it is showing month-wise charts for me. Then this is how the aging module of debtors look. Then there is name of debtors, what is their closing balance, what is the weighted average days, and in how many days, how much amount is pending to be received. So I guess it is taking a lot of time due to Zoom being running on the same time, and the screen sharing module is creating a problem. Yeah, so this is how the entire MIS looks, and it is created within a minute. You just have to plug this with your Tally. You have to open your Tally, download our software, and you have to click in our software that what entity you want to fetch and for which year you want to fetch. So there is an year support. You can view this data for any particular year. So then you have balance sheet and other statutory reports as well. For this, we have created a visualization so that you can see what components of this balance sheet and what is their composition. So you can see the entire balance sheet as well over here, which is reflected in the Tally. It doesn't prepare its own balance sheet. It takes directly from Tally. Then there is another ledgers module where you can see each and every ledger in detail. It is very simple. Like as you see a ledger in Tally, same way you can see the Tally in here, and you can even download your entire Tally in Excel format in just one click. So that will come. So this is a ledger module. Okay, so it has opened. So you can see that the entire Tally will be shown here, and you can select any ledger that you want. Okay, so this is how the Tally module in this works. So we, as I said, that collaboration of all the factors, legal and financial, have to be in a single platform to be able to give a comprehensive view to our clients, right? So the third problem is managing compliances. As I just showed that how the compliance module is working. So the four problems that it's solving is the compliance configuration. You don't have to do the configuration. Then related information like copy of return, date of filing and acknowledgement have to be there. The compliance tracking is automatic. You don't have to do anything. It will automatically fetch information and mark your compliances as done over here. It is not just for GST, it is for TDS, MCA, income tax, and trademark. And ESIPF also, if it is applicable to your client. And extensions are always there. So with Legally, you get a lot of automation. And so I can say that at least two employees' work is done automatically by this software. The current implementations that we have done, we have close to 500 entities that are working in it. And they have, so for a single client whom we worked, he was able to see status of 852 compliances in just one go when he onboarded the data on this software. Then this is a special dashboard that we have created only for chartered accountants, where you can view the status of 120 compliances in one view. So this is a proprietary view of ours that is actually created by most of the professionals for their internal CA firms as well. So here you can see that this is the entity names. Then these are the months till which the time today has elapsed. So October has started, so it is showing October. until where the compliance of that particular client has been done. It is not only for 3B. You can select any particular compliance and it will show you a real-time view of that compliance. So it will generate the view on the fly. Then there are many other analysis that we have created. So this, the first module that you saw, is basically a compliance, basically a entry module. Then where you can configure entities, but for professionals who want to manage their entity, this is the module which you can open through this analytics part over here. When you click this, it will open this. So in this, you can see the penalty of all your clients at one place. If I click this, I'll be able to see only the clients which have TAN number and not all the clients. And then I can see what clients have, how much penalty pending. Then compliance applicability, that which compliance is applicable to, so what compliance has been made applicable to which client. And then tally, when the last tally was synced and when the extended due dates are synced, and the compliance overdue dates are there, extension dates are there, then these kind of analysis are there in this. So as I showed that, you can see all the compliances in one view. Then moving on to the next slide. Then there is a configuration module. So I have shown you that how the compliances are there, but how do you configure those compliances? So when I go to configuration of compliances, there is a very, so we have kept in mind that it should be the entire onboarding of an entity should be within 1 minute. So that so that it doesn't consume a lot of time just to configure the software. The work of the software should be more to provide the output than it receives the input. So when you go to any particular compliance, you can see all the registration numbers for that particular client, for that particular client. And then there is all the compliances are there. So you can tick any one of them and click save. The problem that there is another problem with the software that they do not provide a stop date, that when this compliance stops, so that if I disable that compliance, I won't be able to see the history of that compliance. But when I put a stop date, the previous record stays and the new record starts generating. So it is as simple as that. Just tick the compliance, click save and start and put the starting date. Sometimes starting date of a compliance in an entity is different for different compliances. Sometimes they take GST number later on. Sometimes they are forming the company later, or they have started filing the TDS return at a later date. So this is like a very easy configuration module for the compliances, which like any CA can do it in minutes. Then the dashboard we have explained, that I just showed you the entire dashboard for a firm. Then there is penalty tracking and challan tracking history. So when we were building this, we received a lot of feedback from the chartered accountants that they face problem in challan tracking of TDS as well. So there is a report section for each of your entity, and there are innumerable reports which we keep on adding every week. So as you can see that there is a challan summary in this. So all the challans of all your clients will be present here automatically when you add a TAN number. And then you can enter the amount of that challan that was paid in that, and then you can download that. So you don't have to maintain an Excel file. So once you save this, you will also be able to download the challan from this panel only. So you can mention the amount over here so that for future references, you do not have to maintain a separate database. It is there only. It is automatically updated, and it helps you maintain the track of all the challans. Then you can also see for like when you are providing this to your employees, you need to track that whether they have entered all the challan details or not. So I'll show you that in this, as you can see, that there are companies which have 24 challans and 18 are unfilled challans. So 25% have challans have been filled. So this is how you can track whether the challans have for your, all your entity, all the clients have been filled or not. So this is the entire view of building the analytics module was to actually give an overview of the entire entity data that has been entered in legally as yet. So this is how you can track the challans. And then I'll also like to show you the entire penalty history is also available over here. So we have received a question that we have something for MC as well. Let me just finish off with this and then we can go on to that also. So as you can see, that entire penalty history is over here, which is also reflected in your main dashboard. You don't need to come here. Then as I said that, do we have anything for MCA also? So in your compliance module, you can configure your MCA compliances as well. So the MCA compliances will keep on coming. Now you want to see whether the compliance has been done or not. So here is your company law compliances. Then if you want to see that whether this compliance has been done or not, here is the entire report. All the documents that have been filed till date for any particular company will be displayed here. Now we have received a lot of requests to also implement a one-click download option for all the documents, which is a public search, and it is underway and it will be there. And for company secretaries, there is a wonderful module coming up, which is a board meeting management module. In that module, you can add all your directors, shareholders from Legally itself, and then you can create all your notices, minutes, then CTCs and minute books for all the board meetings of your company in just one click. And along with that, you can also maintain your cap tables. Okay, so I was muted somehow. Okay, I'll continue. So I guess everybody is able to hear me. If not, you can just inform me. So so you will be able to create the board meetings and all there itself. So we have a query that we need to fill the database or it will be automatically populated. You do not have to fill the database. You just have to implement the basic information like enter the SIN number of the company, enter the GST number of the company, enter the TAN number of the company. And as I said, the 75% of this entire software will be automatically filled with information and dashboards automatically. We also like help chartered accountants implement this, and sometimes there is a confidentiality issue. For that, we sign an NDA very happily because the systems are so secure that we are sure of no data breaches, and we follow all kind of cybersecurity policies. So that is a comfortable part for us. So if anyone is thinking of onboarding even 1,000 entities, that can be done in a day. This is the like level of software that we have built so that the implementation is fast, the onboarding is fast, and the software gives you more than the input that it takes. And the implementation is just once. You have to enter those details once and it will do the work for you perpetually without any additional efforts. Then penalty tracking. So we have written why the penalty tracking was being ignored till now. Due to the distributed ID and password management, monthly tracking and lack of knowledge where to go. So as discussing the ID password management, this was also a very big issue. And we received feedback from our clients and we built a password manager. So if you have 100 clients and 20 of your employees are managing those passwords from XYZ places, and even if your client changes the password, they can just enter the password in this software. So when you share this with them, they can just enter the password over here and you will be able to view password of any company from anywhere in just one click. So like you can select any company and list passwords and you will be able to view all the passwords of that company in a single panel, and you can even change it from here. You can just change it and save it. So if your employee changes it, he can save it and it will reach the client and you as well at the same time. Talking of sharing and how you can collaborate with your stakeholders. So there is a grant access module in this entity. So what you can do is you can just tell your employee or client to create a new ID you can enter the legally ID here. So this is the legally ID that you get on creation of your entity. And after that, you can start selecting the companies that you want to share with a particular person. And you can give them read or write access. So this is these are the two kinds of access that you can give them. And it will create a matrix for you. So this is the entire matrix that you get, that whether you have provided them edit access, read access, and you can just revoke them. This is the button for revoke, that revoke you access. So this is how it works. And you can create an environment, you can share the same entity with n number of people. And as I discussed, that the softwares are very costly due to the minimum number of users they require. Our software is due to being SaaS based. I won't say that it is our specialty, it is the specialty that it is a SaaS based software. So you can create unlimited logins, and for all your clients and employees, we don't charge anything. So it is just, it becomes free for all your n number of users that you want to onboard on this entity. So I have shown you this report. This is the penalty tracking report for TDS. Then there is a document automation module that people require to do document automation in their company, like creating a POA from time to time and creating, so for people who are doing trademark, that is POA, rent agreements, DIR2 for people who are doing company incorporation, or any other kind of invoices or any other kind of any document that is frequently created in the entity. So problem is that we need to provide rent agreements and employment agreements to a lot of our clients. They ask for service agreement proposal format. So this software automatically takes care of that. There are 50 predefined formats, which if you fill, you get them in PDF and Word formats. But it is not limited to the 50 parts. We keep on adding 3 to 4 documents every week. And we also provide a service where you can implement a document within your entity only. The document that you share won't be shared with anyone, and it will remain in your entity only. So I'll just jump for a minute to the document automation module. So you can see there is a category of documents. You can go to any particular document. You can click create to create that document. Then after that, you can name it anything. You can start a process of stepwise information collection. So we are towards the end of the presentation, and we have shared a link in the chat that we want you to fill if you are interested in the software, and we'll give you a personalized free demo and even provide you a 10% discount from ConnectEasy for joining us within this webinar. So then you can fill this information, and then you can go to My Documents. And in My Documents, you can see all your documents at one place that you have created, and you can download the PDF or Excel Word version of that document, where you can see that I can download the PDF version from here itself. So this creates a environment where I don't have to keep a physical records of all those documents that I have created till date. Then, so this is it. So I guess we have discussed like major portions of what kind of solutions a CA firm needs and how we are helping them. We also realize that there is a long way to go, but this is an initiative where we are helping CA firms to where we are helping them to create an environment of their own, to create an online presence of their own without having to spend a lot of money. So we are getting a lot of queries about the prices. So prices are basically as much entities you have, the pricing will be based on that only. The basic pricing starts with just 10 rupees per client per month. So even if you have 100 clients, it would just cost you 1,000 rupees. And the kind of service and automation that you get would be like if you, even if you keep a 2,000, 3,000 rupees article, it would be very much justified even to keep that. So this is it. I guess I would hand over to Mr. Virag Shah for taking it over. And I guess it was useful. And if you still have any questions, I guess we have a lot of time to cover the questions as well.
Yeah, Modi, there are main questions regarding the pricing only that you have clarified. Few people joined little late. If you can tell what you have covered in the first part, the first 20-30 minutes in a brief, again for 5-10 minutes, in a brief, because few people join late in the session, so that will be great help.
So in the beginning, what we were discussing was that due to evolution of technology and the kind of burden of compliances that has fallen upon the chartered accountants, there is a need for compliance tracking and client management solutions, because it is very important to engage with the clients these days, the number, so that we can provide them information in real time and we can do the compliance tracking. Then we discussed about the practice management, the balancing act of the practice management. Nowadays the compliances have the pricing that we are getting for compliances is too low. Like when the GST started, the pricing for return filing used to vary between 3,000 to 5,000, and everyone here would agree with me that it has fallen up to 25% to 50% of the original amounts. So we are balancing between average revenue that we are getting per client, the quality of service that we want to provide, and the cost of that quality is falling upon us. So when we say that to increase the quality, the cost increases, the ARPU should also increase, but that is not actually increasing, which is leading to decrease in quality, for which we need to increase the technological implementation in our entities. And with decrease in ARPU, we need to increase the number of units to maintain the current revenue. And if we are increasing the unit, it again means that we are increasing the cost in terms of number of employees that we are keeping to interact with those number of clients. Then we discussed the global scenario and the software scenario of today. So the software today are basically limited to operational softwares like invoicing, accounting, return filing, and there is a lack of analytical softwares that can gather data from a lot of places and provide you a bird eye view of your entire entity or the practice. So and the kind of solutions that analytical systems can build is a client facing system that are collaborative, based on RPA and having a centralized repository. So out of all these points that you can see, the client facing solutions are very important, because currently most of the communication with the client goes on in WhatsApp and emails, which is very difficult, because to keep that in a centralized manner is not possible. And collaborative, because today, like, one professional is working on income tax part, one is working on GST part, other is working on MCA part, and the people are not able to get the entire picture at any time. For example, if you have filed for a loan, then you need to apply for an MCA approval in some cases. Then if the accounting system is linked to your compliance system, your company secretary will be able to see that, okay, there is a loan and I need to inform them that there needs to be a board resolution. RPA is basically a new technology, robotic process automation, where the robots do most of the work for you of collecting the data and maintaining the database. Then discussing the factors that have like important factors for which has led to the requirement of centralized and standardized repository, is that we need a centralized repository, because in case tomorrow we have a new if we have a new law that says that, okay, if any person has more than a lakh rupees of sales a month, then this additional tax need to be paid, then we will be able to do that analysis only when we have the information of all the clients at one place, and that too in a standardized format. Otherwise, we will have to open the file of each client one by one and check whether the compliance is applicable or not. So not only the centralized information is important, it needs to be in a standardized format, which I know most of the professionals try to do by maintaining Excel sheets in a particular format. But then again, it is a redundant thing, because it is not available online. You have to share it with everybody, and then tracking is not possible. And there is a lot of human intervention which can lead to deletion of data, or like misinformation. Like someone can mess up the data anytime and you won't be able to know. So collaboration is again the most important point in this. Is when we have a lot of data and a lot of people are looking at it, they are looking at it from their own perspective, and they may find some of the things that are not consistent with their version of what they were looking for. And this sometimes brings up new concerns in a legal structure. So when we have a lot of information at one place in a standardized and a meaningful format, we might be able to mitigate some of the risks that we don't even know exist. Then we discussed the kind of softwares that we have in market. So most of the softwares are basically operational that we are using, and that too at a very high cost, I would say. And analytical and management softwares are gaining momentum, but the technology is not up to the date. And the reasons for technology not being up to date is SaaS-based. There is no SaaS-based solution. So SaaS-based solutions are ones that are not restricted to your desktop only. They are hosted on cloud servers, which, as I said, that creates a fear of data security. But even ICI in their seminar said that online systems are more secure because you are when a server is located in your company, you are only providing a firewall on that. But when it is an Amazon server, a team as big as a company or a city is maintaining the data security of that server. So obviously it is more secure. But to get this thing, it becomes a lot of difficult because we are just entering into the technology age. There is a lack of UI and UX investment in India, I would say. I have worked with a lot of startups who actually build the products, but then they realize that the product is good, the operational part is good, but people are not able to use it because the user experience is very bad. So UI is how the software looks and UX is how the software operates. So this has been the most important part of the journey of Legally, because we wanted to give user a very good experience, and rather than just providing an operational software that tracks compliances for them. Then analytical solutions are lacking because of lack of API integration. Again, the software, most of the softwares are limited to people desktops, and the data flow is not there. So data integration is not there, and there are no analytical solutions possible unless there is a buttload of data in the system. Then we have a worldview that what countries. So these are the countries which are basically harboring most of the unicorns of softwares today. So particularly US has adopted this very well, with Carta and Shoebox being your equity management solutions, Clerky being an online registration portal, and Diligent. Diligent is actually a worldwide corporate secretarial management tool. But when we saw that, we also realized that there are some problems with that on the part of operations. That's why we are building a board meeting platform also, which will tremendously help company secretaries. And I would like to say that the board meeting resolution creation software that we have made is actually been implemented on the companies that are led by world's best VCs, including Sequoia, Kalari, Leo, and Pulvi Ventures. The companies of these VCs have been onboarded on the platform, and more than 10 professionals are running it. So this is the statistic that most of us are aware of, and that 30% companies got struck in India due to non-compliance, and then 4,200 crores the average penalty collection. And the last point, I guess, we discussed before going on to the demo of the software, was that 20 lakh registrations are being done online every year, which has led to a gap between the communication of the professional and the client, which has again created a sea of miscommunication and led to non-compliance on the part of clients. So if we have put the information in the system and shared with the client, it will benefit client immensely, and it also creates a lot of earning opportunities for the professionals as they and as when the people know that, okay, you are providing this service also, it helps them get into this. So I guess here we started with the implementation part. So we have another software, question. How to migrate data from this software if one wants to exit? So I would show you that there is an module where you can export all your data. So we have made the Tally exporter, and we are working on exporter for your other compliances and other information. So it is very simple when you say that if you want to exit the software, if this software doesn't have a lot of data that is not available with you, you can just simply delete your account, and you can download your Tally data from here. So here is the all exports. You can go here and export all the data you want. So maybe there are limited features right now with regard to download, but they are coming. And like within 30 to 60 days, most of the things will be downloadable in Excel format from here. So the other question is that whether there is a chance for white label of the software. Yes, we provide a white label. In fact, I would like to show how it works. So in white label, you get a reseller ID. So it is not actually a reseller. It is just the name. We are renaming it to management platform. So in that you get a special ID of your own. So this is the ID of your own company. You can put it in your website as a sign up button. And whenever someone creates an account, it doesn't come to us, it comes to you. So you will be able to see all the people who have registered specifically from your website, and we won't have any access to it. Only you will be able to see it and review it. But that person always has an option to complain that, okay, I have by chance added this, added into this, and then we contact you and resolve that issue. And obviously there are some additional charges for when you create the white label. This, that is basically 5 to 6x of your current module, that is 10 rupees per client per month. And then you also get a white label in the form that you can replace this biz with your own entity's name. Like if you have ABC Private Limited, you can just type abcpvt.legally.com. So people will be able to recognize your company as well. So do we have any other questions? So we have a question that when we export the data, can it be used in some other software? So that depends on that particular software. That is why we haven't kept any XML or JSON format. It's simple Excel format. Even if it is not importable, you can, you have all the data, you can manage it in Excel and import it into other softwares. And I guess, I hope that you don't need to export and shift to another software because we are building this and we are open to solving any of your doubts, queries, and additional features. We have actually implemented some of the features that were told to us by our clients, and we specifically informed them and gave them the benefits because they improved our software. So I guess we don't have any other questions, and I would request Virag sir to take this over.
So participant can ask question if they have any question in post it in the question tab, then we can take up as well.
So we have what services
for all are requested to fill a form as well. The form is shared, then it, the legally team will connect with you for the demo as well, and you will eligible for a discount as well as a trial. Also, you can have a some trial, and if it is a help to you and you are practicing form, then it will be, you can continue to use as a very low cost product, and the automation is only the future. So all are requested to fill the form as well. Over to you, Mudit bhai.
Yes, as Virag sir said that you can actually have a 30 day free trial for a limited number of entities, and you can experience the software, and our team will fully help you in onboarding your current entities. Now we are getting some question about employee task allotment. So as I said that this software is based on sharing module only. So when you share 10 entities to your employee, he will be able to see only those 10 entities, and in this compliance view, he will keep on getting. This is another compliance view where you can view the compliance tracker of all your clients for all the compliances at one place. So if you have shared only 10 entities to a employee, he will be able to see only those particular compliances that have been allotted to him. So although it is not a particularly task allotment software, you cannot allot additional tasks from this. But what you can do is you can allot them entities, and they'll be responsible for doing compliances for those entities only, and they can see all their overdue compliances over here. Then we have another question. That can be connected to Trello? No. So third party integration is only to government portals, not to other softwares. So there is no connection to Trello. So time tracking management of staff is not possible. As I said that it is not entirely the that kind of software. You can track your employees. It is related to your client's compliances and exposure and for document management. So we have a software, we have a question, how GST returns file will get updated. So there are public APIs available, as ClearTax is also using them, and there are many other software, even CompuTax. So we have put those APIs just to a different use. So we have government APIs where we fetch the information into this portal, and using artificial intelligence, we mark with which compliance has been filed and which has not been filed. Along with that, we get a lot of information like date of return filing, which we automatically put it in this. There is a software upcoming, like which will be gsthelp.com, where gsthelp.com was also our platform, which we'll be integrating in this, and you can reconcile your books with 2A in one click from within this software. So yeah, I have got the question twice, that how the GST return will file get updated. I'll just show it to you once more. For example, in my company, I go to compliance management and I see my calendar that, okay, these many compliances are upcoming. So if any accountant from my firm files the return, it will automatically show that it has been filed here as soon as it is filed. You can see even for TDS, it is showing it has been filed, and I haven't marked this as filed on my own. Then there is quarterly GSTR1 that has been marked as filed, and there is 3B that has been marked as filed. So these all, this is like automatic. For I would repeat that for GST, TDS, income tax, trademark, ESI, PF, and MCA, this process is automatic. So you can see that it was filed just yesterday, and it has been marked as filed in this portal automatically. So this is a API based process, as I said, that AI and APIs have been used to manage this. Can we schedule an automated customized email reminder to clients? Yes. So this is another requirement that we have, not only emails and SMS. So we are working on it where you will be able to send a automated reminder to clients to submit their information for filing the returns. As I showed you, that you can connect your tally. So even you can tell your client to connect his tally and directly get the information here only, rather than asking it on the mail. And you can file it on the government portal, and it will show here. So this will create an environment for entire tracking. So what all, there is a question that what all compliances can be tracked. So I would like to go to this screen where I can show you all the compliances that are there. And there is income, so like two panels I can show. And if some compliance is not there for some reason, you can just contact us and we will update that compliance in this within 24 hours. So supposedly you say that I want to add a particular, even general compliance. So I'll show you even general compliances that I want to add a quarterly or monthly MIS. You can even do that here. So all kind of compliances you can track over here. You want to add a new compliance, you can contact us and we will add that compliance particularly for you. That is not an issue. What are the, can we link calendar and get customized notification? So yeah, so notification system is embedded in this. You get a notification every 2 to 3 days regarding what kind of penalties are pending for your clients, what kind of compliances are upcoming, and how many compliances are pending on your panel, so that you can visit and view it. So this is an automatic feature in this, where you get all the compliance notification and updates from time to time. And even if there is a new feature in the product, that also you get. So I'll show you another, like this I've shown for income tax and GST. I'll show it for another one, that where you can see that what kind of compliances you can track. So all the compliances are there, they're just divided between laws. So I guess 90% of the compliances you will find here. If you want any new compliance, I have said that you can just directly approach us and we'll add it within 24 hours. You can raise a request here. This is our AI based chatbot, where you can even ask for a demo and it will give you a live demo of how the software works. Okay, can this software fetch data from Zoho books for 2A reconciliation books? So not from Zoho right now, it is from Tally only, and we are integrating QuickBooks and Zoho in that order. And but you will be able to fetch 2A, entire 2A data and reconcile it with your books on AI basis. When I say AI basis, it will be like if you have a GST invoice number, GST001 in government portal, and you have invoice GST1 in your tally, then also it will match based on the amounts and based on amount and the similarity between the invoice numbers. This is the ML logics that we have input in this. So that feature will be available. So yeah, so in KMP employees, the open database gives us the data about the name, the DIN number and the address, I guess, of the director, and rest all you have to fill. You can upload any kind of document like ID cards, Aadhaar cards, address proofs, appointment letters. Appointment letter you can just create within this also and attach it there. So like you can maintain a lot of information, but not every information is automatically fetched. As I said, 75% of the entire information in your legally journey will be automatically filled, and rest you have to fill manually. Not only you have to fill, you can share it with your employees. They'll fill and it will get synced into your login, and you will be able to view it anyway. So I guess we have more questions. Just let me see. For TDS filing and data to be fetched from Zoho itself. No. It is not a filing software. You are not filing any return from this software. This is just a software where you can view the return filing compliance status and do analysis of your data points over here. You do not file the softwares from here, file the returns from here. This just shows whether the return has been filed or not. It is a compliance tracking software, not compliance doing compliance return filing software. So any other questions? Client access, you can obviously give the client the access. You just have to tell the client to create an account on biz.legally.com. And after that, he has to give you this ID, this legally ID of his. Then you can go to grant access. So for supposedly a client creates an ID name, ID, and he has ID number 402. Okay. And then I'll enter the 402 over here, and his entity is supposedly Aadhaar Setu. So I'll select, and he has only one entity. Maybe he has two entity. So then I'll give him write access and I'll grant permission. So when I grant permission, he will be able to see he will get this kind of view in his dashboard. Just let me show you how the shared entities appear in this. So this is how the shared entities appear at the end of your entire entity structure, entire entity list, and then he will be able to view it in the same. So how it works is you just load the entity that you want, and it will be, you can see the change happening over here that this entity is currently loaded. I just go here, click change, and it will bring me to this. I can add or change it to any other entity. So for some people who arrived late, I can just show the manage entity feature till we get more questions. In manage entity feature, you can add a lot of data, but we try to fetch most of the data automatically. Just let me open my company. Yeah. So I can go to detail section over here. Yeah, so you can, like, we are right now again sharing a form that you can fill. We'll give you a personalized demo, onboard your clients, and provide you like free demo for your entity, and then you can have a 30-day free trial and even a 10% discount for connecting through ConnectEasy. So this is the basic details section where you can fill the entire details and store them, and share capital structure. A detailed capital structure can be created. It is very useful for people who are going for funding and have a lot of shareholders and directors in their company. They can create an entire cap table structure in this. So in shareholders, so someone has asked who is the owner of the company. So I happen to be the founder of the company. So we have built this entire software. So KMP and employees details and ownership details and my document details. So I guess if we need to cover anything else, we can know the questions. There are no more questions, I guess, that are coming. And I have answered all the questions. If any question is to be clarified again, you can just let me know. You can also put your questions on our website. Like it is, we'll put this in the chatbot as well, or chat window as well, www.legally.com. and you can put your doubts over here. So the frequency on which it is updated is 24 hours. It updates every night and the new information is populated over here. We are working on providing a button within the system where you can click and all the data of your particular login will be fetched whenever you want. So, but that button will have a quota. Like if you have purchased for 100 clients, maybe you get a 10 or 20 quota where that, but you can press that button anytime and it will update the information for you. Okay, so you can drop us a message over here, or at the end of you can also get all the details from this chatbot as well. So you can like drop us a message if you have any questions for future. I guess we have put the website link in the chat. So pricing structure, I would just reiterate. For we charge 10 rupees per entity per month for your clients. So if you have 100 clients, the pricing structure is 1000 rupees per month, which is lower than any employee that you would hire to do such a work. Or if you have 20-30 entities, the pricing structure will land around 200 and 250 rupees. And but we charge a minimum of 150 rupees even for 10 or 5 entities that you get. But we provide a 30-day demo so you can test it out on 5 entities. So waiting for more questions. Yes, so there is a question that income tax demands are also auto-populated. Yes, within by Monday you will be able to see you will be able to download your return copies. If there are cases, you will be able to download notice copies and acknowledgement copies of those cases that are pending against you for all the years. So do I need to address any other questions? So if till then more questions come, can you please repeat? So the pricing structure is 10 rupees per entity per month. So if you have 100 clients and those, and if those clients have even 10 GST numbers, the pricing will remain same. So the pricing is per company. If you have a private limited company, you can add it and it will be charged 10 rupees and you can add any number of registrations within that entity. So if you have 50 entities, it will be 500 per month. And if you are purchasing for the entire year, we charge only for 10 months. So can clients be added afterwards? Yes, clients can be added anytime after that also. We by default provide 2 to 3 clients above because sometimes there is a error in client creation. So someone has said that we have income tax clients 1500. So we can work for this much bulk. Obviously the pricing will reach a lot high. So we can discuss this. You can drop us a message. We'll create a pricing structure specifically for you because you just have income tax clients. You don't need the other APIs. You would like to opt if what you are mentioning is available. Yes. So obviously this is possible. 500 clients are already there. You can take it from there. Mr. C.A. Hirenji, you can connect with us and you can, for our income tax, you can drop a message also that I asked for 1500 clients and we'll reach you back after this webinar. Because you don't require other APIs, we can obviously decrease the pricing structure for you because you just have income tax clients. So we can work that, we work something for you which will be affordable for you as well. So I guess the pricing structure is clear. And for white label, if anyone wants a white label of their own company, the charges are a bit high. So it is once only, like as I said that if you have a private limited company, you don't need to pay for each GST number or each TAN number. It is just once. So if you are a private limited company with 10 GST number and more than one TDS number and ESI PFP numbers, trademarks, more than 50 trademarks, So this is entire, the entire structure is just PAN based. You can assume that we are charging only for PAN. So you can fill up the form. We will call you and provide a demo whenever you want. It is not a limitation for us. We can provide a demo anytime, and Mr. Ajit will call you right away after this, and Mr. Hirenji for this pricing structure. And it will be multi-user or single user. As I said that it is multi-user, I'll just reiterate this by showing it. So you can go to this My Entities tab and go to Grant Access tab. And here you can share any number of entities with any of your clients. So your clients can create login on this. It is free of cost for all your clients and all your employees. They can create any number of accounts on this, and then they will provide you the legally ID. You can enter your legally ID over here and select the entity that you want to share with them. If there are more than one entity, you can keep on selecting that. And after it is done, you can give them read or write access, and they'll be able to see only those entities which you have shared with them. So if you have shared with 10 different people, you will be able to see all the entities, but those 10 people will be able to see limited entities that have been shared with them. So, and I would like to say that same ID, even if you have created one ID, any number of people can open the same ID from any number of devices at the same time. It won't hang or it won't create any problems. The servers are pretty fast. So like even if 100 people are opening the same login at the same time, they'll be able to see all the information without a lag. Can we get a combo offer for income tax, say 400 clients? Yes. So if you have only income tax clients, as I told Mr. Hiren also, we will be offering a lower pricing because you need only one API. You don't need all the APIs. So waiting for more questions, and please fill up the form. I will request Mr. Viraksha to push this over the mail also to the people who have joined this, and you can fill up the form for the demo, and we are giving up discounts for ConnectEasy, and we thank ConnectEasy for this great platform where we can connect with professionals and share our information, and so much beneficial for all of us.
Thank you, Mudit bhai, for your kind words. So friends, whoever registered in advance, we have already shared the this interest form or Google form on your mail. You can check that as well. Mail after 2 p.m. you can check that as well. Whatever received after 2 p.m. In your mail, you can check. If not received, already posted in the chat box as well. So you can check that. A few people are joining late and people are joining now as well. So if they are missed this session, they can watch on our YouTube channel. We will upload soon on our YouTube channel as well. You can just find out by hashtag ConnectEasy on YouTube, hashtag Viraksha. You will get our channel and we'll upload their entire video. You can check in detail as well, along with the form as well. So at least you can have a trial of 30 days as provided by legally that Mudit ji already told. You can check that, and if you find it useful or beneficial for your firm, the pricing is also very economical or less than a one employee as well, what Mudit ji is told for this type of work. So would like to tell all to subscribe the subscription of this module. It's very beneficial. And the automation is only the future. Excel and other, you can check that, but it's how you will be making a track. Like so many changes in the due dates and all that as well. Even the penalty amount and the charges and the interest and all that. So at least you can check for the trial period and check it really beneficial. Mudit ji has developed a wonderful product out of his own experience, would like to say. It's not anybody has thought of. It's Mudit ji's own experience, and he has created this.
Yes, and the software has evolved with the feedback of a lot of chartered accountants as well. And I would say that, as I said, it is might be only 5-10% all the way where we want to take it with the kind of integrations we are bringing in future.
The best part is the integration with the government website. So that is a very nice part of this, that it's a cover and that taken the burden of all that aspect as well. So friends, there is no question as is having mobile app. There is one more question from the Rajkumar Kothari ji. He's from Aurangabad, I guess. Rajkumar ji. So he is asking.
Someone is saying the pricing is too low. I guess then you should subscribe to this because and then the low pricing is good thing, I guess. And then how many users can have access to this at minimum? So minimum is like one, you have to create the account. Maximum is there is no limit. You can create 1,000 users. We don't mind. So is there is having a mobile app? Yes, it has a mobile app also. You can go to the Play Store and download Legally app. And when you log in, you are able to see the same thing as you are able to see online. And you can, even if you don't want to download the mobile app, you can just go to biz.legally and log in and it will function as a mobile app. It is a mobile responsive website. So I would like to say on the low pricing remark that that we have higher end modules also, which we can discuss. And what charges additional users? So I said that no charges for additional user. You just purchase for your entity. All your employees and clients will be free. We won't charge anything. So all your clients and employees will also be marked as particularly belonging to you, and we won't maintain the information for them. So there is no problem in that also, that your clients will be totally safe. So you can inform us, and these are our clients, and we'll just put them in a separate module where we don't access them, or we don't mail them anything also. We just mail them the transactional notifications regarding the pending compliances that is automatically generated by this system. So next year charges, so the modules, the charges that you will pay this year will continue for whatever time you take the services. There will be no increase in charges. So the charges will be same, but there will be additional modules. So if you want to take another module, like there is a track my trademark module. As I explained, the trademark tracking is a problem. So we have an AI based module where you can track the trademarks. So if you want to take an additional module, that will be chargeable extra. But for the same module, the pricing will continue to be the same for additional clients and coming years. So as I would like to say that, as you've seen, the pricing is very economical and we don't plan to increase it. It's what we have decided upon, and it won't increase in future. It's just we'll be charging for more services if we are providing more of them. But the modules you subscribe on day one. So currently what I have shown you is all included in the 10 rupees that I'm telling you. Viragji, I guess your voice is muted.
Yeah, so few people are still joining now also. So would like to tell them we are, end of this meeting and we are closing soon. You can watch on our YouTube channel. And on YouTube channel, there are multiple videos as well, or 100 plus or 150 plus videos, which are very useful for professional. You can watch them as well. One of the very nice video on LinkedIn aspect of the professional, so you can watch that as well, and many others you can just subscribe and check the other videos. This also recording will upload on the, our YouTube channel, and you can check there as well.
People who are joining now can fill up the form. We'll just once again share the link, and you can fill up this form for a personalized demo that we can provide after you like subscribe to this you fill up this Google form, then we can provide you a personalized demo for this. Okay. you can ask comments in the YouTube video and ask questions in the comments of YouTube video as well. We'll get back to you for this, and you can visit our website also, where you can drop a message to us and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. I'm putting the link in the chat once more of the website as well. I guess we can wind up.
Yes, yes. So thank you so much, all the attendees. Thank you once again for joining an interactive session by Mudit ji. He has solved each and every question as well. So wonderful interaction. And the automation is only the future. Again, I am saying the same thing. Then you should adopt automation in your firm, whether it's you this software or any other software, for the purpose of your professional work. So with this, we are concluding this today's session, and all are requested to be connected with us for your professional growth. We are have done more than around 400 webinars in this pandemic, and apart from that, previously we have done physical session as well, but that is limited to Mumbai people only. In and around Mumbai only can join that as a physical. But now the all around the world people are joining us. Yesterday, a few days back, we have an internal audit, and in that we have a people joining from Muscat. A few days back, we have a transfer pricing session, in that we have people from Bahrain and many other countries. India, all over India, we are people joining. Eastern region, South region, Central, Northern, any you can take part. Even Northeast people are joining, Assam, Guwahati, and many others as well. So you can be in connect with us. With this, we are concluding today's session. Thank you so much, Mudit bhai, for this wonderful session. And very interactive, and the product is really very nice and very useful for all the attendees, all the practicing professional, whether they are chartered accountant, company secretary, cost accountant, who is doing the professional work for their client. They can subscribe this legally software, which is a very cost effective as well. Would like to thank you here, Puneet bhai, and the entire JCF office bearer as well, to allow us to have a jointly event of this with Jain Chartered Accountant Federation. So it's our privilege that we can have a joint webinar of this session. So thank you so much once again, Mudit bhai. And with this, we can conclude this today's session.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for the most important.